Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to solve this problem. If the cosine of A equals 12 thirteenths, and A is between 270 degrees and 360 degrees, find the sine of 2A and the cosine of A over 2. All right, so we know the cosine of A is 12 thirteenths. To figure out the sine of 2A, we could use the formula for the sine of 2A, which is 2 sine A cosine A. So this tells me I need to know the sine of A and the cosine of A. Remember, 2A is a completely different angle, right? It's twice as big as A, and you can't just multiply this by 2. So I would need to know both the sine and the cosine of A. I do know the cosine of A. I'm going to have to figure out the sine of A. I like to do this by drawing a picture, but you could do this other ways. So let's see. A is in quadrant 4. So I'm going to draw a picture in quadrant 4 where the cosine is 12 thirteenths. So that would be 12, this would be 13, and this is going down 5, so I'm going to write negative 5. Now, I'm not saying that length is negative 5, this is my y value. So from my picture here, and remember, A is actually this angle, okay? Because I said it's between 270 and 360 degrees. If I said it was between negative 90 and 0, then it would be this angle going down right here, but I didn't say that. So that's not it. All right, so now we could look at that picture and determine that we know the sine of A. So here we've got we already know the cosine of A. Oops, sorry. Wrong color, that's too light. The sine of A from the picture is negative 5/13. Right? So I already knew the cosine of A. Now I know also the sine of A. So I can plug it in to this formula. So this would be 2 times the sine of A is negative 5/13. Cosine of A is 12/13. And remember, this is 2 over 1. Nothing cancels. So it's going to be negative. And that's going to be 120 in the numerator and 169 in the denominator. So my answer is negative 120/69. Now, if you want to think about this, you're taking this angle and you're doubling it. So it's going to be pretty big. And when it goes around again, it must end up over here in quadrant 3 where the sine is negative. So you should like eyeball it and see if that makes sense to you, that the sine should be negative when you double that angle and take the sine. Now I've got to do the cosine of A over 2. This is where it's also important to pay attention to this information here. If A is between 270 and 360, then we can take this inequality and divide all three parts by 2 so that I find out where A over 2 is. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to divide all parts by 2. And that gives me 270 divided by 2 is less than A over 2 is less than 360 degrees over 2. So I have 135 degrees is less than A over 2 is less than 180 degrees. And now that tells me what quadrant A over 2 is in. And where is that? A over 2 is in quadrant 2. And in quadrant 2, is the cosine positive or negative? In quadrant 2, it's negative. So we have to keep that in mind because now we're ready to figure out the cosine of A over 2. So here was our problem. If cosine of A equals 12 thirteenths, the second part of this problem was to find the cosine of A over 2. And before we get started, we first figured out where A over 2 was. It was in quadrant 2, and so the cosine will be negative. So we're going to use the formula for the cosine of a over 2. All right, so here's the formula for the cosine of a over 2. It's plus or minus 1 plus the cosine of a all over 2. But we're going to keep in mind for this particular problem, I'm going to choose the negative. So I'm only going to write the minus sign because the cosine is negative since a over 2, right? Cosine of a over 2 is in quadrant 2 where the cosine is negative. All right, so now we can plug in this formula what we know. Well, we know the cosine of a is 12 thirteenths. So we've got negative 1 plus 12 thirteenths all over 2. So we have a complex fraction underneath the square root. So we need to deal with this complex fraction to begin with. There's different ways to do it. I like multiplying numerator and denominator by the least common denominator. And in here, there's only one denominator, 13. So I'm just going to multiply everything by 13. So that gives me still this minus sign. And that'll give me 13 times 1 is 13. 12 thirteenths times 13 is 12. And I've got 2 times 13, which is 26. So I have negative square root of 25 26. Well, the numerator, the square root of the 25, I can take that out. That's going to be just a square root of 25 is 5. So I'm going to have a minus sign of 5 over the square root of 26. All right, well now, let's simplify that by multiplying by the least common denominator. Use a lot of algebra in trig. And so finally, I get my answer. It's going to be negative 5 square roots of 26 over 26. And that is the cosine of a over 2 for that particular value of a. And so we've answered both questions. So the cosine of a over 2 is negative 5 square roots of 26 over 26. The other part of the problem was to find the sine of 2a, and we found that. That was negative 120 over 69. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.